What's up, everybody? How are you doing? Josh here today with another Rovers reaction following the last gasp draw against Charlton Athletic. So here we go, let's get into the reaction straight away. Now, we did leave it very, very late. In the 94th minute, Matty Blair pops up and it's a pretty decent goal from him. He squeezed it in well in the gap with a nice header and has given Rovers a valuable point, I'd say, because by all accounts, Charlton Athletic did have the game in their hands and did control the game. So, from that respect, a good point. But we conceded from a set piece again, from a corner this time. And it's just going to be a case of we have to improve on them. Because otherwise, if we don't, teams are going to come to players and they're going to go exactly for that as the way to exploit us. And they will exploit us because they'll just bomb the set pieces in. They'll just keep them going. And that will be where they'll pick up goals, pick up chances, because we can't, for some reason, defend set pieces. Now, obviously, Blair did save the match for us in the 94th minute, but he almost gave away the match as well. He played in a back pass, and my God, it was the worst back pass I've ever seen. Don't know if he's like the winger Fosu who's got like a touch on it, or he's just miskicked it. I don't know. It was terrible anyway. And basically, he's played in Fosu. Fosu just picked up the ball and ran forward. He's in on goal. He's rounded Lawler. And it looks a certain goal, 2-0 Charlton, but out of nowhere, Tom Anderson is just there, he recovers so well, and he puts in the best last-ditch challenge I have ever seen. Big respect for that, for a defender who can do that, who has the ability to come out of nowhere and fly in safely and deal with it and save a certain goal. So well done for that, Tom Anderson. So yeah, a decent point, but there's a little sneaky feeling coming into it now that it's, you know, we're getting towards the business end of the season. We've gone 8 games without a win. Is that now cause for concern? I think right now it's not cause for concern, but this month is absolutely vital. We've got so many games in this month that are teams in and around us. So on Tuesday we go to Walsall, who are below us by 2 points, but they've also got 2 games in hand over us. Then we also host Fleetwood, again I think they're 3 points below us, with again 2 games in hand over us. And of course, you know, we've got the big one, Rotherham away. Those 3 games are going to define Donny's season. You'll look back and say that was a turning point, whether it's, you know, positive or negative. So, obviously, I'd say a target for that is to just get 1 win out of those. I think if we can get at least 1 win out of those 3 games, that will put us in good stead for not going down. And now, obviously, on a Saturday night, yeah, you're looking through the scores, you're looking through social media to see what people are saying about the game. And I saw a stat float around that was from the season where we were relegated to League 2 about how after the winning a couple of games over the festive period, we went on to not win a game in 17 games, and obviously that led to us being relegated. And people are saying, you know, wondering whether it's going to be the same sort of situation now. We won our 2 games over Christmas, and then following those 2 games, we haven't won 8. I don't think we can draw too many things from that. Yeah, it was Ferguson was in charge then. Yeah, we, you know, went down and we didn't win the game, but we've got a long time to go until we can, you know, until it's 17 games without a loss and we've gone down. So I wouldn't get too caught up on that stat right now. But maybe if, you know, a couple more games where we don't go out without a win, then it might be the time to sort of start worrying. So obviously with that comment, I also saw a lot of anti-Ferguson comments about Fergie out and all that. So I can understand it. I can understand why people are saying Fergie out, Fergie out. You know, you haven't won any 8 games. We need something better. But I just want to say, like, I'm sort of on the fence a little bit. In fact, no, I'm not on the fence. I think we should stay with Ferguson, and here's why. Realistically, with our sort of pulling power, our attractiveness, and our finances available, what would be the point in getting rid of a manager and having to pay him off for the rest of the season? He's on a rolling contract year by year. What would be the point paying him off, bringing in someone else who, realistically, like, are we actually going to pull someone? Are we going to get someone in who can really improve what we're doing? Because I don't think we can. So yeah, I am Fergie in. I think there's no point in getting someone else in. No point in trying to off him and find someone else. But obviously the game against Charlton was memorable for the reason of James Coppinger, our icon, hero, legend, whatever you want to say, every word is applicable there. He made his 500th league appearance for Donny, and just what a servant he has been. What an absolute baller. He's done so much for us, so much for our club, and we've got such a good relationship, the fans and Cops. He's just been absolutely phenomenal for us. You can't say anything else. He's been fantastic. He's been there for 14 years, and like honestly, he's done so much. He's won us a league title. He's single-handedly beat Southend, pretty much, with that hat trick. I mean, come on. Like, that was one of my most memorable moments as a Rovers fan, seeing him just dazzle Southend, just absolutely blow them out of the water. He was absolutely fantastic, and there's so many things that you can pick up that he's done. He's been stalwart for us. He's been there longer than anyone else. He's been there when others have gone and moved on. He's just been fantastic, a fantastic servant. So, Cop, congratulations on behalf of the fans, and you know what a fantastic accomplishment 500 appearances are for one club. I don't think you'll see that many more people at clubs do that, so you know it deserves massive respect, which we of course give you, and hope you get a new deal and stay here and retire here, because you deserve that as well. So guys, that is it for another edition of Rovers Reaction. I don't know if you will have noticed this, but I've tried to plan this one a little less and just freestyle it, be a bit more off the cuff, because I feel like you get more of a better true perception on what I am feeling, what my thoughts are, instead of where I just sit down and chalk everything off and write a proper script that I just read completely off. I feel like it's a bit robotic, that. So let me know what you think, if you prefer a more planned, method going into the videos, or just this more sort of freestyling off the cuff sort of thing. I do thank you for the support you've given these videos, also to people who aren't here for Doncaster Rovers related content. I do have a podcast that is currently exporting on my laptop over there, and will be up within the next week. I did that one with Adam, did it quite a while ago now, it was in January, so that will be uploaded in due course, and I will try and develop some more content that's not just Rovers related. But to the people who are here for Rovers related content, thank you as well. Great support as usual. Again, I'll put it in the Facebook chat and Facebook group to get my video out there for you to see. And I do appreciate likes, dislikes, if you give me a comment why. And any more subs that come, because like I said in my previous video, there's a lot of people watching the videos that aren't subscribed, so I know that all you have to do is literally sign up to Google, to a Google account. It takes literally 2 minutes, and once you've done that, you can just click that big red subscribe button down below, they'll be there, down below, and yeah, subscribe to it, support this channel, and the more support, the more we can grow. So thank you very much, guys. I've been Josh, this has been Rovers Reaction. You'll see me soon. Yes. Bye.